Open any image in Affinity Photo, PC or Mac. And once you've done that, go up to the Select menu and then go to Tonal Range and select Midtone. Of course, it depends on the image as well. You might go for shadows if it's a very dark or something image. However, once you've got that, what I want is an outline around that selection. So select and outline. Now I want a fairly chunky outline, so I'm just going to go say for 4 or 5, and this will depend obviously on the size of image. Now I've got a 3800 sized image here. You might have a different size, so it's just vary it. So I'm just going to go with 5, say 5, and click apply. You can also smooth it as well. If you want to use a bit of smooth, go to select and then to smooth, or maybe feather. But I'm going to go with smooth. I'm just going to set it a little bit there. 4 or 5, and as you see, as soon as you do it, it changes, makes it a bit smoother. Click apply. Now what I want to do, I want to copy and paste it. So I'm just going to go to edit and copy, and I'm going to edit and paste. And that creates a new layer with that selection. So the image that was inside that selection is being pasted to a new layer. Now what you can do, and I'm just going to quickly deselect that so you can see it. There it is. I'm also going to remove that selection. So deselect. Also, I'm just going to click there. There's a little padlock. I don't want that padlock because what I want to do is I want to move this layer above. So I'm just going to click there and just drag that up just above this one. Now what I can do, I can add layer effects. It's a live effect, so you can change it at a later point if you want to do that. So I'm just going to deselect that again. And I'm just going to go down to effects. So effects, and I'm just going to go for 3D. And you can vary, you can change the setting. You can see you can make it a bit darker. You may want that. Gaussian blur. I'm just going to want a bit of a blurring. Again, trying to smooth it. I want a nice smooth effect. Don't want a really sharp, coarse effect. So I'm just going to smooth, sort of blur it a bit. And also, and again, it's live. This is the key thing. Of course, if you applied other filters, it would make it not live, destructive. So bevel and emboss, and you can again vary this and you can modify the settings. Change pro and you can move it around. Maybe go for that. I want a bit of depth to it. So you've got a bit of, like, you can see the ripples there and paint. And close. Now with that done, I'm just going to go back to this layer now and select that back on again. So you can't see it. However, what you can now do is you can go to the filters menu with that layer selected. Make certain that layer is selected. Go to filters and go to distort and displace. Drag it up here, and you can see there's an option here, load maps from layers beneath. That's what that is, that layer beneath. That's the layer. So click there, and it's probably can hardly notice it, but it creates a nice, all the way around these clouds, you've got this nice sort of distortion, nice glassy distortion effect. And of course, you can vary the settings. So maybe push it up really quite high. You don't have to, but I'm doing this for, obviously, so you can see it on the screen in the tutorial. So just push it up fairly high, and you can see now what happens. The distortion follows all the way around this image, but it's a nice smooth, you've got lovely ripples and sort of globules of sort of glass that have been sort of added to this thing, following all the way around the contours of the design. Click apply. And of course, you can always, if you want to, you can always go to filters, apply it again, or maybe go to layer and fade the displacement map. You can always just fade it. Maybe you might think, you know what, that's a nicer effect. Maybe you've set it to 50%, 60%, or maybe go for blending modes and run through those. You might think, oh, that's a nicer effect. Creates maybe a more painterly effect, sort of paint, like it's been painted with these sort of dabs of paint. You've still got the image, but you've got a sort of like a nice oil paint look effect. Well, hope you found this of interest. Always adding new tutorials all the time. Any comments, any questions, please put below. A like or dislike, always great. Thank you much.